The Great Plains. Once among the greatest grasslands on the planet, this ecosystem supported unique habitats with abundant vegetation and wildlife. Today, what was once a vast prairie wilderness is now mostly a complex network of farms, ranches, and small towns that were built as the country grew westward. But there are still places where that original untamed landscape and its creatures remain. These hidden away and hard to get to wild places hold tremendous value for all of us. And there are those who are working to protect and preserve these places and their inhabitants. Michael Forsberg, the noted photographer and conservationist, is one person committed to raising awareness of the inherent value of the Great Plains. His work has taken him to the far reaches of the plains and has brought him face to face with species most of us never have the chance to see.
Up on the hill is a guy named Scott Stevens, who's a biologist for Ducks Unlimited, and there's a lot of grassland birds nesting out here in these grasses, and he's located a willet nest. And a willet is a really big gray shorebird that nests in the grass. So we're gonna put a little remote camera next to the nest and set it in place and then pull clear back on a hillside and watch and hopefully take some pictures of the willet at the nest.
The way I see it, one of the biggest challenges we face in trying to communicate about these areas in the plains like the Missouri Coteau is the fact that, you know, the picture that people have in their mind of these areas is driving along the interstate, and they don't have a very good appreciation of the real beauty and importance of these areas. So from my perspective, Mike's work really helps open people's eyes and allows them to see that there is real beauty in these areas and, you know, why they're important from, you know, from a national perspective, from a continental perspective, really, in the case of this area.
Always work with guys like Scott because they're out here doing research, studying these birds, and then to have a few pictures to go along with the birds that they're studying, you know, helps science too. So I think we're helping each other out here.
Mike Forsberg's new and revealing book, Great Plains, America's Lingering Wild, is a portrait of one of the most overlooked and least understood regions in North America. NET Television and Mike are teaming up to produce a feature-length television documentary that will focus on Mike's journey to create his book, the continuing story of the settling of the plains, how the region has changed in the past two centuries, and what is at stake for us today. We'll take viewers on behind-the-scenes adventures with Mike and some of the people like him who are committed to America's lingering wild.
Nighthawk is a volunteer pilot organization that provides pilots and aircraft in support of conservation efforts. Being able to see an issue or a landscape from the sky is something that really brings home the scale and extent of whatever it is, either a environmental or habitat degradation or just the special nature of a landscape. I kind of go out for the celebrity photographer missions, and they're all so different. Mike's just been a real fun person to work with.
What we're on is the 1.1 million acre Charles M. Russell National Wildlife Refuge in northeastern Montana. And we're here in September at the peak of the elk rut.
We always think about elk as being a, you know, animal of the mountains, but they're really also an animal of the plains, and they were in the plains in huge numbers, you know, 150 years ago.
There's several thousand elk that use this Missouri River break system, and there's an elk viewing area down here in the river bottom that's really the attraction for a lot of people to come and watch elk doing rut behaviors, the same as it was when Lewis and Clark came through here.
You know, it's also a hunting season going on right now, and those really are good drivers of the local economies here, so that's important too. So it's nice to be able to have, you know, a spot like this.
I really enjoy the conservation message he's trying to send, because it's that education and developing that appreciation for the things he and I cherish is why I'm an optimist.
Shot in high definition by NET's nationally recognized production team, Great Plains, America's Lingering Wild will feature Mike's first-hand account of his travels, totaling over 100,000 miles to every state on the plains. Viewers will also get a glimpse of the effort and technical mastery that are necessary for Mike to capture the rare and elusive species native to the Great Plains in such intimate and unique portraits.
Bats are very vulnerable to population declines. They're a species that congregates in small areas like these natal caves. I think what Mike is doing and what you guys are doing is a great thing. I mean, one of the things we really struggle with here in the Great Plains is building awareness of wildlife and the issues surrounding them. You know, a lot of times the issues we face are pretty subtle and they're not easy to explain. And I think what you guys are doing, it kind of putting it in layman's terms and pictures and video for everyone to see is really great.
Our journey with Mike will let viewers experience things that very few people ever get to see firsthand.
So what these guys are doing is they're dusting, and the goal is to hit every hole. It's called Delta Dust, it's Delta Methrin, and the goal is to kill fleas, basically, that are plague vectors.
Out of the 19 blackfoot ferret reintroduction sites, we're probably number two, population-wise, just the number of animals.
The elusive black-footed ferret lives only in prairie dog towns. Thought to be extinct just a few decades ago, today only a few hundred animals remain in the wild. But now both the prairie dogs and the ferrets are being killed off by plague.
Even if the entire basin was wiped out except for what we've dusted, we figured we could save probably two-thirds of the population. So right now we've lost half the habitat, but we still got two-thirds of the population. It was roughly 300 in 2007. Last year we're probably sitting around, 200 animals still.
Black-footed ferrets are completely nocturnal. Not to say that you won't see them during the day, but really the best way to find them is at night with a spotlight, looking for their eye shine as they poke their heads up on a prairie dog burrows.
Where we're going once we get past the swift fox down there, dusting that today.
This is a big hunk of colony here, and dusting is absolutely a thankless job. I was attempting to trap a few last night so we could vaccinate them against sylvatic plague, a disease which is moved into Kanata Basin and is deadly to both black-footed ferrets and prairie dogs. Once we capture this ferret, I can compare it to the database and know exactly where it was last year, how far away it's moved, and things like that.
Is what happened last night typical or atypical? Or?
Fairly typical. That you'll end up going through part of the night where you're thinking to yourself, gosh, there's not a single ferret out here, and then all of a sudden, boom, it seems like a switch gets turned on, and all of a sudden they're there.
Viewers will be right there with Mike in his wildlife blinds and in the skies over the far reaches of the Great Plains, experiencing firsthand the land, the spirit, and the species that Mike photographs. Along the way, we'll meet many of Mike's friends who care deeply about the plains and who are working hard to preserve and protect what is left of the lingering wild. From wildlife biologists to pilots, to farmers and ranchers, and to school kids who are using Mike's book in their classroom studies.
Come on in. Come sit down. Come sit down.
I became acquainted with his work, and then I brought it into the classroom, not sure if kids would connect with it or not, but they really did. So then we started kind of using it and bringing it into our art and our reading and all sorts of subjects where we could.
Okay. This is what I photographed this morning. So remember what I said that was?
Prairie chickens.
There you go, prairie chickens. And you know what? These guys weren't very far away from your school here. Across this trail right here, something would walk across that trail, that camera would just know it and it would take a picture. And so the first time, it didn't take a picture of anything. The next time, it took a picture of a raccoon, and then
oh my gosh.
What is that? Close. Close.
Bobcat.
Good job.
They wanted their picture with you also.
I would be very honored.
One, two, three.
Buffalo!